Hey, what's going on, guys? In this video, I want to show you an inside the waistband holster made for a commander size 1911. Now, this one here is made by a company called Ritchie Leather Company. I honestly don't know much about them, but this is called the Stakeout. This was donated to me by a buddy of mine who doesn't need this holster. So let's just kind of check it out. Now, you know, he recently learned that, hey, I heard you got a Colt lightweight commander on trade. I even traded with somebody. And I got a holster for you for that 1911. So I said, okay, I guess I'll take it off your hands. He's just like, yeah, just take it as a donation because I don't own a commander size 1911. So here it is. And he said, you can make a video about it. So I just want to thank you for donating this to me, even though I do not carry a 1911 at this time. But guys, I'm going to admit to you, I've been shooting my 1911s a lot more increasingly. I'm starting to think, maybe I should carry a 1911 again. Too soon to tell. So, we'll leave it at that. But I'm not carrying a 1911 right now. But I have this holster here to kind of show it to you guys. This could be an option for you. You know, I don't know much about Ritchie Leather Company. I was told that this guy used to work with Alessi up in New York. But other than that, I don't know much about his company. Upon initial look over of this holster, it does look of high quality. The stitching, I mean, look at that. The molding, the boning, if you want to call it that. It just looks really nice. So it does look of high quality, this holster right here. Now that I think about it, it looks very similar to a Milt Sparks Summer Special, Summer Special 2, whatever you want to call it. And it's because it has these two loops right here. So it kind of makes me think, wouldn't you just go with like a Barnell's, you know, standard Summer Special 2 holster? You can just order it. Maybe, but I noticed right off the bat how this is designed right here. Flat back. Look at that. Flat back. That equates to when this goes inside the waistband, it's going to lie flat right against your body, and that's A+. So that's pretty nice. But I would consider just a Summer Special 2 that's readily available at Barnell's. You just order it and can have it, you know, within a week. This guy here, I don't know if he's even in business anymore. I'm not really sure. I probably should have did my research before doing the video, but I just want to show this to you. So in my usual fashion, I'll show you what this looks like on my person. And you guys can check it out. Might be an option for you. What I'm thinking is, you know, because I got this Colt lightweight commander on even trade, I did a 1-for-1, as you guys know. Because it has an aluminum receiver or frame, and it is lightweight, let's holster this thing up and check. What the? Wow, that's tight. Did he even? Wow, this thing needs to be broken in. I don't think he even used it. I know he doesn't have a commander. Well, commander size right now, but wow, I don't even think he used this holster. All right, this thing needs to be broken in. But that's what it looks like holstered up. But what I was saying when I got off track here, sorry, being that this is a lightweight commander and it's a lightweight 1911, I do think this holster here, this system right here, is going to work out. Back in the day, early 2000s, when I would carry a full stainless steel, carbon steel, government size 1911 that was 40 plus ounces, and I would use a Summer Special 2, whatever you want to call it, I just dealt with it. I noticed that at times it could sag into the pants some more because, you know, government size 1911 is a little hefty, but it didn't really bother me. But when I first started using the Milt Sparks VersaMax 2 or a VersaMax 2 style holster where they spread out the belt loops further, that's gold. You know, if you're going to carry a 40 ounce 1911, I would highly suggest a VersaMax 2 or that's, you know, that design with the belt loops spread out. These belt loops being so close together doesn't distribute the weight that well. I mean, it will work, and with this lightweight commander, it definitely will work. So this holster here, I can see working with this specific 1911 because it's lightweight. But with anything heavier, you know, I would tend to want to get the VersaMax 2 style inside the waistband holster. Those work out very, very well. I like them a lot. And I could carry a 40-ounce 1911 with ease. It just works out. It's really cool. But with this one, I think this is going to work out. I'm looking at this. It looks like this would sit actually really low in the pants. So this is going to be a deep concealment. Well, it's going to ride deeper into the pants. So that's pretty good. So we can check out what this thing looks like on my person. But yeah, it looks like a really nice holster, guys. So I guess this is an option for you. I mean, I don't know if this guy is a custom maker, you know, if he's got like 16-week lead time or something crazy like that, then it's probably not really worth it. I would just go get a Summer Special 2 or Summer Special Type 2 holster that's readily available, like a Galco. Or, honestly, I would check out a Versamax 2 style holster over something like this. But if you do have a lightweight Commander or a 1911 with an aluminum frame receiver, this might be a good option. Or this style holster will work out for you. Alright guys, well, let's check out what this thing looks like on my person, and you know, we'll see how it works out. Alright, so let's check out what this holster looks like on my person. This is the Ritchie Leather Stakeout inside the waistband holster. And it feels really nice. It's, you know, the 1911's profile is flat, okay? The back of this holster is also flat, so it goes right up against the body. Very comfortable, actually. And you know what, being a lightweight Commander, it kind of reminds me of the Pug Nose. It's just very lightweight. Not a problem. If you wanted to draw, just pull it out, and we are safe. One-handed reholstering, not a problem. I kind of like this, guys. You know what? I kind of miss carrying a 1911. Oh, what's going on? So, yeah, not bad. It feels really nice in that holster. It just feels good. Hey, so if you have a lightweight Commander or a 1911 that is lightweight, you may want to look at a holster designed like this one here, like the Stakeout holster. But even a Summer Special 2 will work out really nicely. Yeah, it's pretty nice. I like it. So I'm going to have to look at the 1911, but I don't know, guys. Let me know what you think about this holster, or if you have any comments or questions, let me know. And as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.